Lisa Punchinello. Lisa Punchinello was the Don's wife.
Mona Sachs. Lisa's evil twin.
Your safety's off, evil twin. You might hurt someone with that gun of yours.
Lisa's the damsel in distress. I'm the professional. I'd blow you away without batting an eye.
Sure, and you can check out my credentials splattered all over this joint.
Jack couldn't have framed you, not the state he was in. We're after the same slime bag. Angelo Punchinello's the one who murdered your friend and framed you with it.
You know this for a fact?
I've got my sources.
I don't have a clue these days. I just shoot them as they come. Who put a contract on the Archfiend?
This one's mine. I hate the guts of that sadistic wife-beater. Why not pool our bullets for this one?
I thought you'd never ask. My finger was starting to twitch.
How do you like your whiskey?
I'm easy, as long as you don't try to slip me a Mickey.
You're a real angel, Max.
It was good stuff. Tasted sweet as honey going down.
Nothing personal. Can't risk you going berserk and getting Lisa killed.
Got drugged!
The nightmare was always the same. Violent shapes moving in darkness, old and ugly. The killer's mad laughter was a riddle filled with wicked innuendo.
Oh my god, I remember this.
Somewhere, the baby was crying.
Fuck. These baby screams and stuff? This is, Oh man, I remember this. Whoa! Trippy! The hallways get, like, longer and you have to go... It's like a nightmare that I have. Fuck. I have no idea where I'm going. Oh, these hallways actually. Holy shit, scared the crap out of me. I am so confused right now. You can actually roll. Okay. I got the same spot where I started. The fuck? Oh my god. Okay, so I went left. This time I'm gonna go right. Cause that's where I
am. No, please, Max. Why? I just need to.
Okay, I guess I got this way. Follow her voice, I guess? I don't know. I'm so confused. I need a map for this. Oh, here we go.
Should have known it when we found you snoring next to Lupino's corpse. A comedian, huh?
What?
The pictures were filled with good old times. Alex and I had a few moments of glory between us. Crime-fighting comrades, the best in NYPD DEA collaborative team. Good-hearted macho bullshit like that. I would have given anything to have him here as my backup. No such luck. No luck at all.
Oh my god, this is worse. Okay, let's go through here then. Oh my god, not this.
I really love to watch cartoons. Captain Baseball Batman.
Oh my god! Don't tell me I didn't save it. Oh my god, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Fucking bitch had to drag me so I can stuck in this shithole.
No!
Okay, let's see if this goes to the same spot. I think this is a giant loop. Yes, this is it.
Should have known it when we found you snoring next to Lupino's corpse. A comedian, huh?
The pictures were filled with good old times.
Okay, here we go.
I really love to watch cartoons. Captain Baseball Bat. Captain Baseball Bat Boy is my favorite.
Okay. Damn it! It's a dead end. Damn baby crying. Yeah, this is the weird part of the game. Where you're like going through your memories and stuff. Oh, this is a nightmare, I think. I think I gotta go this way. Oh no. Yes! Save.
No, 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 please, God, no.
shoot them full of holes, blow them to bits, vaporize them, disintegrate them. No matter what you do, they'll still be back, good as new.
Michelle's diary lay on the table.
Ah, shit.
Max, no, please, Max. Why? I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.
Murderer! You killed her!
Nothing like that ever happens in the real world.
I woke up in a bad dream. My head felt two sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne, I envy your name.
And the killer was smiling.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara, as in you cry a lot? He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
Oh, shit.
Nothing wrong with a little laugh now and then. Take me, for example. I love to watch cartoons. Cartoon violence is a fascinating thing. Let's take a break. I need to take a leak and maybe grab a cold one at the bar. Don't worry. I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, and the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking into place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the goon with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless. It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder, at the head of the Punchinello family. I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. I guess I had a soft spot for a pretty face. But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore. They had dragged me back to the basement of Lupino's hotel. I was beaten, bruised, and blue. I felt like the chair I had broken to get free.
I was just here. Jesus Christ.
All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide-and-seek with them.
It's Frankie's turn. We'll take care of it.
The fuck? Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my God. Oh my God. I gotta Okay, that was a bad idea. Let's see here. Tab. Okay, don't go in there. Don't go in there.
What the hell? Hey, what is it?
I guess I really have to sneak this one through. Fuck. I just follow them. Are you fucking kidding me right now? I think I made the jackpot. Nice! I went through the entire fucking thing without killing one single person. That was actually really good.
It's me.
How do you know it's me? Fuck, man, these guys are like so... Oops. Yeah, I know, I gotta save. Oh my god. God damn it. There's like no... Oh, there it is. Wow. Fuck! Wasted too much life again. Way too much life. Fuck me. I gotta keep saving.
Things were fast going from bad to worse. The men in blue had come and gone. They had decorated the place with chalk outlines and tied it together with yellow tape. The cops who had stayed behind were dead. Frankie, his boys, and I had the place all for ourselves.
Nice.
Just forget about it. Hey, just forget about it. That crazy witch, you should have heard her. She was a real scream when the boys caught her trying to cap the Don. Oh, that's friggin' bad. To the trio? That's even worse than what Frankie's doing to that poor bastard downstairs. She's gonna take a long time to die.
The mobster muscle on the phone was talking about Mona. Punchinello's trio were nothing but bad news.
How do you clean out this place?
More evidence that Punchinello didn't like me much.
The fact remains that all the victims so far identified in the Ragnarok shooting have been known criminals, many of whom had large doses of V in their blood. Reliable sources say that Max Payne was also among those killed, although no body has been recovered at this time.
Reliable sources. That meant somebody thought the Mafia had me, didn't want the cops snooping around anymore. The body would be delivered to them barely recognizable. Case closed. Don Punchinello had the power to be that reliable source, which was no news. But his news was old news.
Nice.
Framing me hadn't been enough. Don Punchinello had put a hit on me. He wanted me dead, and it had been important enough for him to give written instructions to Frankie about it.
Max Payne should die like a dog for the trouble he's caused.
I am. Don't worry, I will save.
I know I can trust you to give this matter the dedication it needs.
Save. You see how old this game is? Like, there's no emails or anything like that. It's just like letters, papers, stuff like that. Like the internet. There's no computers anywhere.
Hey,
Nice pants. Nice pants, mister.
The hotel bar was fast developing quite a history. True to his words, Frankie was there, having a beer.
Jesus Christ. How the hell did you get loose?
Got bored waiting. Thought, what the hell, we could just as well finish this here.
Seriously? Really? That fucking fast? Really? Ugh.
Hey!
Really? Really? That fast? Wow. I took all the pills. that I had. I won't be able to do this. Wrong with me today? I'm just gonna wait for my HP to fucking fill up. We've got like no good weapons. Fuck me. Okay, let's do this. This shouldn't be this hard.
The hotel bar.
Save. Wow, come on, what the fuck, seriously? Wow, I can't, I don't know what the fuck happened. Holy fuck! That was one hell of a goddamn fight.
Thank you. You've been a lovely audience. Had enough?
I don't play with girls anyway.
Unfair!
I spotted the tail as soon as I left the hotel. A big black Mercedes. I'd seen the car before. That time it had heralded impressive explosions. Vladimir was back.
Bang. You're dead, Max Payne.
I might have laughed if I remembered how. What's this supposed to be? Cops and robbers? Look, you want something with me? Get in line.
Peace, man. Relax. You know you are a real news item. Armed and dangerous. I am going to make you an offer you can't refuse. I've always wanted to say that.
It's a bum rap. I've been framed.
Well, that's a moot point. Whatever you did or did not do, I'm sure you had good reason for doing it. Want to hear me out?
I'm listening.
Punchinello messing with V is bad for business all around. But that's not all. There is this guy, Boris Stein, used to pull jobs for me. He's the captain of the cargo ship Charon. Now the bastard turncoat has gone over to the other side, Punchinello's. The ship's loaded with high-res hardware, guns, my business. If Punchinello gets hold of that cargo, he's won and I have lost. And you'll have your work cut out for you. If you want to get to Punchinello, you will need heavy-duty persuaders. I am just the man to get them for you. Change the ship back under my flag, maybe pop two in the traitor Dime's head while you're at it. You'll get enough guns to start the apocalypse. You in or out?
Let's get this show on the road. Vladimir was one of those old-time bad guys with honor and morals, which made him almost one of the good guys. None of us was a saint. The Brooklyn riverfront was a maze of rusty containers, sharp-boned cranes looming up from the snowstorm. On a night like this, you couldn't help but think of the dark army of dead men sleeping with the fishes, cement shoes in line. No Minotaur lurked in this labyrinth, but somewhere out there, on the clanking deck of his cargo freighter, the skipper of the Charon was waiting, like the ferryman in the River Styx.
Damn this game.
What?
Knock, knock! I guess I have to turn on something inside. When will I get sucked? What? How the hell was he in- Oh my god.
For the K-Ron
you
was waiting,
fucking kidding
like the
me.
Ferryman of the River Styx.
God. First. Fuck. Mm-hmm. Ooh, fuck me. I am dead. Fuck!
What the? Hold it.
Locked. Damn it. Why would there be like a house outside? Man, that would be a shitty job. Okay, that was a accidental dive. Okay, I think that needs to be moved, right? Yes. That's pretty good. Save. Oh, that's shit again.
Hey! What the?
Jesus, was this game like edited or something? Like, seriously. Yeah, like, was this game, like, fucking edited? Because it, like, I don't remember it being this hard. Fuck. Holy shit, this guy is, like... piling through guys right now. Jesus Christ, this guy fucking threw a grenade like 5 feet in front of me.
I doubt if the letter was a receipt.
Ooh.
Where dude come to town to do more than just sort out family troubles. Exhibits number 1, 2, and 3. A briefcase of money, a sniper rifle, and an envelope with one
sniper
printed on a fold
acquired
expensive paper.
Mayor.
It didn't sound like a mafia contract at all. It was too cold and too to the point.
Nice. That's gonna get me good stuff. Oh shit. Killers, save. Da 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 da, save. Oh, I can't go there. Oh. Holy shit, why the hell did it explode like that? Shouldn't have exploded like that. Fuck, man. So many people I'm killing today? It's not even funny. Fuck, this guy took too much HP away from me. Wow. Can't believe even that works. The rats with oily water. Fuck me. It's a lot of guns and ammo here, but making no good use of it. Let's see this. Oh my god, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Wow, since when the fuck does a shotgun go that far? What? There's no way I fucking killed him. Are you kidding me? Wow. Jesus, this is insane. What? What? That didn't kill him. Jesus Christ, that didn't kill him? What am I playing this on? Fucking bullshit. What? How am I supposed to get on top of that? Fuck. Oh, here we go. Extra stuff. Is there fucking shotguns in there? There is. And painkillers, nice. need a rifle. Yeah, I need a rifle, man. This is getting ridiculous. Okay, there we go. Okay, save. Tab. Oh, I remember this part. This part's pretty cool. What? Did the camera kill him? Wow. I think the camera killed him or something. That was pretty, crazy. Oh my god, these fucking gunshots. Really? Oh my god, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Fuck that, I'm not going to the other one. This is stupid. I must have... I don't know what I'm doing. Whatever. This is, terrible. Save. Well, that went well. That fucking nade. That nade was really good. Holy shit. Really? Are you fucking kidding me? That was bullshit.
Got him dead.
Oh my god.
I had found Boris Dime's ship.
Wow. Fucking face first. Face. Yeah, fucking face first. And that didn't kill him. Oh, man. Okay, well.
Rust had crept over the side of the cargo steamer a long time ago. Boris Dime would be on board. I'd have to smoke half of his crew to even get near the gangplank. Guns were probably being kept in the hold, buried amidst the rats and oily water.
Really? Fucking shotgun goes that far? phone here?
I'm Angelo Puccinello here.
Angie, tell me, how much did Dime cost you? I bet it was more than his name.
Max Payne.
Right the first time.
You're dead, punk.
You sure you're not confusing me with Boris here? But you are right, of course. Pretty soon we should get together and have a talk.
You son of a...
Pissing Puccinello off was a dangerous game. But when people get mad, they make mistakes. I should know. That's where I wanted Puccinello, mad enough to trip over his own feet, preferably into a grave.
Yes.
Dime.
Dime.
Dime. Okay. What? I don't know if I killed all of them. Yep. Yes, finally. Oh my god, so fucking accurate. So good. So much better.
Did you get everything you need?
Check.
I owe you. Anything you need.
This is my solo. When I'm through, Puccinello won't be anybody's problem anymore.
Clear as vodka. But anytime you get between a rock and a hard place, just whistle. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
You really get a bang out of this big-time gangster act, don't you? Even with all this firepower, I figured I couldn't get to Puccinello at his manor. I could only hope that he wouldn't pass a chance to hear me beg to see he's won. This is Max Payne. I want to cut a deal.
Payne, you're a dead man.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. I got your ship and her cargo. I want to meet. No pain, no gain. Capiche?
You know my restaurant?
Yeah, I know it.
One hour.
Puccinello's restaurant had seen better days. Snow was falling like ashes from post-apocalyptic skies, but that was outside. Things would soon get hot in the Don's restaurant. I knew it was a long shot, Angelo Puccinello actually showing up, but there was no crime in hoping.
What the hell is this? Oh. explosions. Wow. Wow. Fucking hit right in the face with a holy shit, that's awesome. I'm not gonna lie, that's pretty fucking sick.
Janella was burning to get me. The feeling was mutual. He was trying to put out my flames with gasoline. Mobsters have been guarding a real treasure. The way out of this disco inferno.
Nice. Ingram.
Vlad had seen my smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving to go, almost drowning out the Banshee wail of the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me.
When this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind.
Angel of Death.
The night groaned with cold. The garden lights flickered nervously. In their light, the falling snow was dead white before the darkness ate it up. I had heard the stories. The trio were mad dogs. They'd have hung the heads of their enemies over the manor gates if the capo had only let them. Punchinello wanted pain. He'd see the pain. The trick in my situation was that there was no trick, no matter what the movies tell you. No rules, no secret mantra, no roadmap. It wasn't about how smart or how good you were. It was chaos and luck. And anyone who thought different was a fool. All you could do was to hang on madly, as long and as hard as you could. Someone had graciously left the back door open for me and killed the guards. My money was on Mona. I knew the trio would be standing between me and Punchinello. I had read their rap sheets, thick as phone books. No one would be walking out of here alive. The numbing cold of the broken night had followed me in. Upstairs, the trio tangoed down the manor halls to the silent rhythm of their murderous hearts.
The blood of
their
victims
rust on their lips. Vince Mignano, Pilot Providence, a.k.a. Big Brother, and Joe Deadpan Salem. The pistol was a frozen lump in my hand, piercing the skin, gnawing me to the bone.
Jesus Christ. Fuck, man. Okay. Well, that wasn't that good.
In death, the thug had been promoted. Someone hadn't enjoyed the Don's hospitality. Someone with a flair for the dramatic. Someone who had let herself out of a locked cell and passed a couple of armed guards. My thoughts were on Mona again. I could only hope she was a good enough gambler to walk away while she was still winning, before she'd run into the trio. The messenger.
The trio, eh? Those three bodyguards. Yeah, I could have shot that. But I didn't. Okay, shotgun ammo's full. Really? Wow. Holy fuck, this guy was like ready to go. Like blasted me. I couldn't even come through the door. Motherfuckers. Yeah, I don't think that death count is accurate. I think we need to add like 20 more. It's getting ridiculous. Not for fucking every door.
It didn't take me long to run into the trio. The word on Lisa Punchinello was that she was a bit of a witch. The tarot cards on the kitchen table fit the picture. They weren't my kind of cards, but I was willing to take a crack at the hand Mrs. Punchinello had dealt. The first card was the tower. Maybe that was supposed to be the manor. It got easy after that. The devil was the master of the house, and death was me coming for him.
Cool. That sounds like painkiller. Holy shit! That was pretty good.
One down, two to go.
Oh, that was just one guy? Damn. Okay, here we go. Oh, into the locked door we go. That was funny. Jesus, this room is huge. Whoa. Look at this guy just fucking hiding back here. The room is huge to be empty, eh? Yeah. Max Payne theme. Okay, let's go through this door. Wow, this is going actually pretty good. From room to room, saving. Okay. Okay, nice. I got a rifle now. Yeah. Rifle is good. Cause it's so fucking accurate. Wow. Okay. Well, that didn't go so well. Okay, let's see. You can keep adding deaths. Oh my god. Wow! Fucking instantly dead. How is this possible? That took like fucking 20 tries. That was ridiculous. That door downstairs is fucking probably open now. Ingram. Save. Yep. Are you?
Stop at him!
You kidding me? Whoa. I don't know if I should have saved this. In the fucking pool over here. Save.
It was too late for her.
For who?
Who's You're this? A real angel, Max.
I couldn't tell whether it was Mona or her sister. The body was a mess. The sick bastard had really gotten a kick out of it. Seeing her lying there got me thinking about another woman's body on another bed. Got me thinking about a fallen cradle.
Oh my god, there's cops now too? I'm still missing one person, I think.
Max Payne.
Talk to me.
Alfred Woden. You've got company. An armed helicopter just landed on the manor grounds. You must hurry.
The more the merrier.
Holy shit.
Punchinello's trio was done for. Whew.
I've got no more bullet time.
Got my door. Hurry. He's coming for me. You gotta hurry. Please.
I could hear Punchinello on the phone begging for help. He should have been saying his goodbyes. Punchinello was a pushover. The moment I stepped into the room, he folded like a deuce before a royal flush.
No, wait. I was just doing what I was told. I couldn't refuse. She's someone high up. Government, maybe. I don't know.
He was trying to buy more sand for his hourglass. I wasn't selling any.
Whoa, shit.
No, I told him nothing.
What the fuck is going on here? What the fuck?
Game over, Max Payne.
Whoa.
I could tell when I was outgunned. It was time to take another beating. The mystery witch was a real barracuda. Trouble on dagger heels, a smoking assault rifle in her hand, and an army of killer suits behind her.
How sweet. I get to kill two birds with one stone.
Sooner or later, it was going to catch up with you.
Mr. Payne. It's time to show you the benefits of my brew. Be a good boy now.
You'd find that Lady Luck was really a hooker.
Ah!
You were fresh out of cash.
The hell happened? Did she...
Gentlemen, we're done here. Take me to Cold Steel.
She had just given me an OD of Valkyr. I could feel green fire eating my brains. They turned to steam. They did a fade on me. I'd never had a chance. The witch had got me just as sure as if she put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger. The shadows rushed me. Bruised mugshot faces hungry for revenge. They knew my weak spots and closed in for the kill. The floor turned into a vortex of green blood. I fell.
Okay, I forgot about this. I'll be right back. Okay, I am back. Here we go. Another dream section, fuck. I don't remember this one.
Who's there? Max? Max, is that you?
Oh my god, you gotta be fucking again, this house?
Where are you, Max?
Locked.
No, please, Max, no, I'm sorry. Please don't, Max, no, please. Max? Where are you, Max? Please.
Okay.
The letter was staring at me. There was something disturbingly familiar about the letter before me. The handwriting was all pretty curves.
You're in a graphic novel.
The truth split my skull open, a glaring green light washing the lies away. All of my past was just fragmented still shots, words hanging in the air like balloons. I was in a graphic novel, funny as hell. It was the most horrible thing I could think of.
Having strayed too close to the constellations on their shaved skulls.
It was a bad line and a prank call. Someone spouting insane babble, I couldn't make sense of it. I had an overwhelming sense of deja vu. The caller's voice sounded oddly familiar.
What the fuck?
The weird piece of paper looked dangerous. There was something disturbingly familiar about the letter before me. The handwriting was all pretty curved.
What?
You're in a computer game, Max.
The truth was a burning green crack through my brain, weapon statistics hanging in the air, glimpsed out of the corner of my eye, endless repetition of the act of shooting, time slowing down to show off my moves, the paranoid feel of someone controlling my every step.
What?
I was in a computer game. Funny as hell, it was the most horrible thing I could think of.
What?
Snap out of it! Try to remember!
It was a bad line and a prank call. Someone spouting insane babble, I couldn't make sense of it. But I had an overwhelming sense of deja vu, and the caller's voice sounded oddly familiar.
Sounds like that person. Is it gonna go fucking deja vu again? Oh. I can't go back out? Everything is like fucking... Wow, it's weird now. Everything is coming together. Weird. What the fuck? What the fuck is going on? Oh my god, not this shit again. Fuck! Okay, we're gonna make that jump. This is so fucking weird. Fuck me. Oh no, 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 no. Fucking almost gonna fall off. No, no, no. Jeez. Can I make it to the other side? Nope. think I need to go down? Okay, I guess not. Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? Come on. I have no idea where I'm going, by the way. I think I'm there. Killing myself?
Max, something happened at the office today. A strange memo. Something about Vikings.
Honey, I gotta run. You can tell me all about it this evening.
Have a nice day, darling.
The bullet holes were rubies on her chest, blood glowing on her ivory skin. She was so beautiful. The killer was smiling.
The flesh of fallen angels.
Slowly, the green nightmare faded, leaving dark stains on my soul that would never come off. I felt like flatlining. I was all shook up. I woke up in a cold sweat, sick and tired to the bone, lying in a puddle of my own puke. The hag had said take me to Cold Steel before it had all gone crazy. It was a clue. The only one I had. It took me forever to crawl back to my feet and hit the road. But when I did, I drove straight to Cold Steel Foundry outside the city. There was a whole lot of action around the place for a freezing winter night. Trucks coming and going, men running. I had the drop on the Mystery Witch. She thought I was dead. I was on her blind side. I was going in. The bad trip had put me in a crazy mood, adrenaline pumping through my aching veins. Staggering on the mill roof in ice and snow and wild wind, I was a ninja. My kung fu was strong. I wasn't hitting anybody. At best, I was Superman and Kryptonite about to fall through a skylight, down to where it was all going down. A half-abandoned industrial area in the middle of nowhere, the factory was a perfect front for any number of illegal activities. In the belly of the plant, molten metal boiled and bubbled like a witch's brew.
Save.